recent years, children have been participating in dangerous and potentially fatal stunts online. From the eraser challenge and the duct tape challenge to planking, where you just lie flat in awkward spots. Now, another challenge is making headlines for the most tragic of reasons. The pass out challenge, also known as hangman, requires kids to choke themselves until they pass out. And this time, it's claimed the life of an 11-year-old boy. So is social media giving kids new ways to risk their lives, or is this just a new twist on an old situation? It is our daily dilemma, and Jess Irvine from kidsspot.com.au joins us now to discuss it. Hi, Jess. Jess, this is just such an awful story, and you just can't even believe that something like this is actually going around now and gaining momentum. Do you believe that kids are actually now in more danger than they have been before?
Look, I think there's truth to both things. I think children or teens have always taken risks in pursuit of acceptance, popularity. But I think now you've got to look at a teen's peer group. It's not just, you know, their friends, their class, the school. It's anyone who's out there. And then you're talking about the scope of influence is so much greater. I think that's where the dangers have actually increased. And also the speed with which these things travel. You know, I was speaking to a friend last night. She remembers being in high school and a group of girls who did, you know, again, self-harming based kind of competitions. She was only two schools over. I never heard about it, you know, and I'm sure she'd heard it from somewhere, but it didn't travel so quickly. And now it just on social media, it goes so fast, so, you know, So
how do you stop it?
Well, I think it always comes down to, and this is, you know, it's an old thing, but conversation with your kids and making sure it's a two-way conversation. And also, I think the best piece of advice I've been given with these sorts of things is it's not one conversation that you have. It's like you're teaching your kid to cross the road. You don't say once, now look both ways, we're done, you know. You say over and over and over again in, and I guess the really key thing is trying to stay calm, but as a parent you're thinking, please hear me, you know, freaking out about it. But having the conversation over and over and over again about the dangers and listening to them about what they're hearing and what they're seeing and what their views are on it, and also talking about, you know, what is the importance of popularity. This is a moment in time, you know, like
it's so sad though. 11 years of age, and this little boy's mother has subsequently come out and said she wishes that she had been far more attentive to what her son was doing on social media and actually being there with him all the time. And I think that also is a bit of a lesson, because I know sometimes with not I mean, my daughters are too young for social media, but you know, YouTube or online, they sort of look at things and you think, oh, that's good, they're occupied for 10-15 minutes, but you really need to supervise constantly.
That's the thing that's not changed, and that's being very attentive, always listening. I mean, even before social media, you know, you had to be listening to what they're watching on videos. You know, you go back to what, you know, and I think that's, you've got to really pay attention all the time. That, I think you're always observing your children.
Laurie, I suppose, if you're never going to be there 24/7. I feel so much for that poor mum, you know, like... There's a limit to what you can do, unless you're monitoring every single thing that your kid is watching, and then they never learn anything, because they never learn any judgment for themselves. So I think.
Let's see what our viewers at home have been saying on this morning. Marie says social media is just making it easier for kids to observe and be coaxed into playing these old games. Parents aren't managing their child's time on devices, nor what content they use. Suzanne says, what has peer pressure come to? It's a case of monkey see, monkey do, and it's frightening. And finally, Nikki says, perhaps parents need to be firm about the minimum age for Facebook. It is sad that some idiotic challenge ended that way.
That's a good point. I thought you had to be 13.
Sorry? Yes.
I thought you had to be 13 to be on Facebook.
It's very easy to bypass, though.
It is, and I read recently that some parents, when they set up their kids' Facebook accounts when they were considerably younger, they said they were 13. Their kids are probably now more like 14 or 15 because they were 8 or so when they were being set up. But now Facebook says they're 18. And so that's what they've got to be careful of. Like, who is seeing that and thinking that your child is now 18? There's all those sorts of checks that, as a parent, I mean, you've got a lot going on you're not necessarily thinking about. But
never leave the house. Just turn off the lights, unplug everything, don't leave the house.
And I will sit there watching you all the time.
Jess, thank you so much for coming in on this Easter weekend.